Hey guys, Max from Combo here, and today we are taking a quick look at the brand new smartphone from Qualcomm. This is the smartphone for Snapdragon Insiders. Not the most snappiest title, but basically this is Qualcomm, kind of who make the high-end, mid-range and low-end chips for Android phones and some Windows PCs as well. They've actually teamed up with Asus to make their own phone, kind of highlighting all of the best Qualcomm tech and all that's packed into this Android phone, and you get kind of a couple of other little goodies in the box as well. So we're just gonna have a quick unboxing and kind of see what you get in the package. Qualcomm's kind of saying this is for its Snapdragon Insiders, so it's not kind of touting this as a mainstream device, but you know, it's still interesting to have a look and kind of see what you get in the box. It's got a unique way of opening the box. We have kind of a little slip here you can read. Kind of just basically saying, you know, this is focusing on highlighting all that Snapdragon Qualcomm tech. And straight away you can see here's the phone. So actually by the side of the phone we have a couple of wireless earbuds. So this package comes with obviously the phone and these master and dynamic earbuds. Should be pretty decent wireless earbuds with full support for Snapdragon Sound, which is kind of one of Qualcomm's one of their Bluetooth streaming tech. So if you can just kind of take the packaging off the phone. Here we go, here's the phone. So it kind of, it only comes in this blue color. You've got some kind of red accents there. There's a fingerprint sensor on the back. One of the more interesting design elements is this little Snapdragon chip, I guess you could say here, will light up. So it can either kind of show a full color, or it can kind of gently change color and stuff. Kind of a nice little design element there, I guess you could say. On the front, you've just got a big display. I'll kind of run through some of the specs in it in a sec. On the bottom, you've got USB-C and a very wide supporting nano SIM card tray. Nothing much on the top. A little flash of red on the power button on the side. So let's just boot up this phone and then we can kind of have a look and see what else is in the box. If it wants to come on, there you go. Powered by Android, Asus. So Asus actually made the device to Qualcomm specs. So we've got a couple of other little goodies in here. This is the earbud case. Obviously that's the case for these earbuds we just took out. Let's open this. So branded with the Snapdragon Sound logo. Is there anything else in there? You got a couple of other little ear tips in there as well for the buds. How sound should sound. There we go, we've got USB-C on the side for charging. So let's just pop those earbuds in. So yeah, these are kind of around £300, $300. So again, this is quite an expensive set actually. This is £1,500 or dollars, depending on kind of your region. So yeah, expensive for kind of what you get, but these are some £300-ish pair of headphones are included, kind of if you will happily kind of take this Snapdragon branding, which is kind of all over the place. You've got little Qualcomm logos on there. So nice pair of earbuds, match the color of the phone. What else do we have in here? We have a charger. So this is a Qualcomm Quick Charge 5 capable device. This is a Quick Charge 5 capable charger. Here's the brick, USB-C on that side. I think that's a, well, I'm not sure, maybe a US plug on that side. And we should have two cables in here, both braided, both feel really nice. This is a USB-C to USB-C, pretty long cable there. And on this side we have a USB-A to USB-C, a little bit of a shorter cable, probably for the earbuds this one. Again, nice touch, two cables in the box, feel really kind of premium cables, much nicer than you usually get with a phone. So nice to see, and of course the power brick as well. And I think the last part of the package is this kind of bumper case. Go. Yeah, it's kind of a bumper style case again with some red accents. So I should just flip around the phone. You kind of want some added protection. There we go. It looks quite nice on the side, and I see it kind of pops in. There we go. So So if you just want some extra protection on the phone, nice to have. Again, nice to see it's included in this kind of quite expensive package. Nothing else. Oh, there is something else. There's a user manual down here. In its own little box. So there's nothing too interesting here. It's kind of a typical user manual. So in terms of specs, on the front we have a 6.8 inch 144 hertz OLED display covered by Gorilla Glass Victus. It's got a midnight blue finish on the back. There is a triple camera, or they can see the logo light up there. The triple camera on the back with wide tele and ultra wide, 500 gig of storage, 12 gig of RAM. This fingerprint sensor on the back is Qualcomm's 3D Sonic Sensor Gen 2. And it also says that you can charge the battery 70% in 30 minutes or 100% in 52 minutes, obviously using that included charger. And as you could probably expect, inside the phone is a Snapdragon 888 processor. Kind of interestingly, that's not actually the flagship chipset from Qualcomm anymore. That's the 888 Plus, but we've not seen any phones with that. So I kind of assumed that this was devised before that chip came to be. Basic setup looks very similar to any Android phone. I believe this runs a fairly stock version of Android, so kind of don't expect too many customizations. This is mainly just about the hardware. See the wallpaper, you've got that 888 5G chipset, Qualcomm branding, but the software looks very kind of familiar if you've ever used kind of an older Pixel phone or a Android One device or something like that. So yeah, that's just a super quick look at the Snapdragon smartphone for Snapdragon Insiders. Very clunky title. Yeah, it's an interesting one. That light up thing on the back looks kind of quirky. As a phone, it feels pretty big. Not the most stylish of device. The screen, 1080p, looks pretty nice, 144 hertz. It should be good for gaming. Obviously, there's a lot of gaming features in the 888 chipset. There's wide 5G support, kind of covering more bands than you typically see on a phone. This is one of the first phones to support Snapdragon Sound, which is kind of why where those master and dynamic earbuds come in. So yeah, it's really a showcase for all of Qualcomm's tech. Whether it will be something that you'd be interested in, you know, I'm not sure. I've only just unboxed this phone, so we'll have to run through a full review process to kind of see if it's worth the $1,500. But yeah, when you see this video, I should have been using the phone for a couple of weeks. So if you've got any questions, remember to leave them in the comments below. If you want to know anything else about this phone, then I pretty much should be able to answer any of your questions. And thanks for watching, guys, and we'll see you in the next video.